Thanks again for saving me back there. We're glad you're safe. I'm Leia Rolando, the reporter who asked to speak with you. Oh, this was for Leia. Okay. Oh, is that you? It must take a lot of guts for a Rizomaxian reporter to work way out on Olympias. Our acquaintance here was a soldier in the battle against Exodus and in the Olympian invasion. Hmm. So you two are from Olympias? Maybe. On top of that, I used to work for Exodus, actually. What? Well, no sense beating around the bush. I'd like to ask you a blunt question. Do you harbor any resentment towards Olympians? I guess I'd be lying if I said I didn't. A lot of my comrades were killed because of the Otherworld Reactor plan, and my family suffered. I see. But then again, I guess the Olympians would say the same stuff about us. I should know. I took down plenty of their soldiers myself. And do you think the two worlds will ever be able to set aside their differences? Hmm. Not anytime soon, that's for sure, but I guess one day it's possible. They say what makes us human is our ability to be rational and not just reactionary. Yes, that does sound like a cheery little outlook, doesn't it? But I guess I have to agree somewhat, being an ex-mercenary myself and all. You're ex a lot of things, Alvin. Exactly how I feel. As a soldier, I'm the one who has to actually take lives out on the battlefield. I have to believe that peace will exist someday. I get no joy from killing, but there are those who do. And they'll do it, not for self-defense or to protect someone, but because they want to. That's not human. Those people are the lowest forms of life there is. I never want to be like that. Ever. Thank you. You've given me some good stuff for my report, but you also gave me a lot to think about. I won't forget what you said. Alright, cool. Is that the end of that part for Leia? It is. I wonder if she has a job report part 4. Who's the last one we have to do? Marksburg. Let's go. Also, we have Muzet's story we need to do. Oh, I almost forgot. On another note, look at all the gold I have. Over 150 million. I'm telling you, all those jobs I was doing not only leveled up the Allium Orbs and my characters, but dang, did it... Kanan baby's still there. I just wanted to look at it for a second. But man, it raked up the cash.
Hello, hello. You rang?
I did indeed. It's time to get... I have just enough to get 1/4 of the thing done. Except I'm short 3,000. I gotta add 3,000 more. Here we go. Here we go. 5 million paid.
I'd like to make an announcement. You've already repaid 5 million gold! You're killing it, Luger!
5 million gold. We are 1/4 done. It's only taken me the majority of the game to finish 1/4. Whoa, my phone! Shut up! I apologize for that. I thought that my phone was on vibrate. I'm putting it on vibrate right now. Just a second. Okay, my phone is on vibrate. I am sorry. I could have sworn I had it on vibrate. Whatever. Too late to do anything about it now. Hey there, Marcus. You doing well these days? I remember this guy. He helped us sneak onto the Paloon or whatever it was. If doing well means working my butt into an early grave, then yeah, I'm doing just dandy. Hey now, quit complaining. At least you got a place to lay low and hide out for a while. Yeah, I'd be in jail right now if I didn't. Of course I'm grateful. You've done so much for me. Hey now, don't start with all that. Just keep your head down and work hard. I know, I know. It's tough breaking the cycle, but I want to, man. I want to work hard and get out of this sort of life one day. It'll take some time, but I'm going to put it all behind me. You'll see, you and me are the same. Yeah, I hear ya. We brought something for you, Marcus. It's from Vera at Spurious Court. You know her? What? From Vera? I can't believe she finally replied. Replied? Phone call. Vera here. Did you give him the stuff? Yep. Then please give Marcus the following message for me. No, that's all. Vera out. Ah, shot down. No! Marcus, you didn't. I did. It was love at first sight. I've sent her at least one letter a day ever since. Whoa, dude, that's pushing it way too far. All the same, please go out with me, my princess. That's also pushing it too hard. Bro, what did I tell you? Yeah, I know. But what can I say? I'm a hopeless romantic. I'm a fool in love. I'm a tortured soul longing for that one connection more powerful than any cosmic force. Dang, man. Head over heels and all that. Give me some of that booze, will you? Just a swig or two. My heart is broken in several pieces. It's a compound fracture. It burns! I need a drink, man! I need a drink! Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm not going to give you any booze right now. Come on, just one swig. You can have this cool hat. What the? I don't want your hat, Marcus. You gotta keep it together, bud. Well, that explains why Vera sent us to deliver booze. Is he gonna be alright? Look, you obviously need some comfort. Comfort. I can't talk. And frankly, I don't think I'm equipped to comfort you properly. So here, have some Ex Machina. Just one swig, though. Oh man, you're the best. Bros for life. poor Marcus. Man, that was cold, Vera, breaking him through messengers. My cats are back, yes. Black dog's muzzle? That's something I can put on my characters? I need more spores, dang it. Wait a minute, I gotta see this. I also got a collar. I don't want to put it on Gaius. Where's Mila? She's my go-to for this stuff. I also got a collar. Can I put the collar on people? Of course I can. It gave it to me. Where are they? Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Black dog's muzzle. Maybe it's an optical illusion, but this kind of looks more like a cat. No? Are you see it? That looks great. Where's that collar? Here it is. A spiky collar for those confident, assertive types. Use it as a headband or bracelet if you want to. Yeah, that fits Mila. This game. I love this game. Anyways. What else was I going to do? I turned that in. I think that's all the jobs I had, wasn't it? I didn't mean Kitty Dispatch. Was that all the jobs I had? It was. So I think the job board is the other way. I was going to go the wrong way. Let's turn in these jobs real quick, and then we're going to go do Muzet's side story. You know what else? We should probably go and check the Colosseum to see if anything new has popped up in the Colosseum, because I haven't looked there in a while, actually. Go and check that out. I didn't mean to hit contract. I don't know why I did, but dang, I've got a lot. I thought that I was, like, honestly getting closer and closer to the end of all of that period, but now I've just got a ton more to do in between this session and the next. All right. And we only have these two exclamation point ones. I'm working on getting the light shrooms, and then I'm going to work on getting the Princess Sia's. I already have one. I need to send the cats back to Mon Highlands to get the other. And then I think I need two more of these. But yeah, man, I wanted to show you guys. I only had like 7 of these left, and I was going to be like, look at how much I got done. I made so much progress, but the game decided no. The second you get back, we're going to like add on a crap ton more, so you can't say that. Wonder how many more elite beasts there are going to be. I wonder if they're going to make a total number of 30. That would make sense. Ah, whatever. Let's check out the Colosseum first, and then we're going to go and look at, not look at, we're going to go and do the, side story for Muzet in Drellin. It's the last side story we have right now, and we may be able to get into the main story, but actually I don't really want to get into the main story in this session, because I'm going to want to do stuff in between this session and the next. Still only novice. Party mode? Still only advanced. Okay. Alright then. So there's nothing to do here. Also, I don't know if you noticed, but I have how many cats? I have 72 cats. Man, I have been killing it with the amount of cats I have. I'm only 28 away from maximum. I'm going to try and get them all before we finish this session. Get all the cats, pay the debt, everything. Anyways, to Drellin, that's where we need to go. I was trying to remember. Where did I say I was going? I've already been recording like over 20 minutes. It feels like I haven't been recording long at all. From Muzet with Love. Oh, this sounds good. This is only your second chapter. Is Muzet okay? What's happening right now?
If only I were more popular with Mila's friends. If they loved me more, then I bet Mila would too. I could try giving them all presents, but what would they even like?
Oh, Muzet. Do you want to talk about it, Muzet? Maybe I should just sneak away. No, we're going to talk about this right now.
I'm trying to think of a present to give to Mila's dear friends. They mean so much to her. I'm her big sister, after all. I have so many responsibilities.
You intend to give presents to Mila's friends?
Of course. It's a big sister's job to look out for her younger sibling. What would make a good present?
Why not give them something they can wear? How about something handmade? I don't think I want to see whatever Muzet would try to hand make.
Some sort of accessory might be nice.
Niakara is known for its traditional handmade ornaments. Those who give them are greatly admired for their taste, and the recipients are always grateful.
How can I get a hold of them?
They're fashioned from harpy feathers, apparently.
Harpies? Where can I find those?
They're said to inhabit Bermia Gorge.
It's a good thing that Gaius knows everything about everything. Fractured dimension?
DODA here. We've detected a new fractured dimension.
Let me guess. It's near Bermia Gorge.
The rift is near Bermia Gorge. We've sent you the coordinates. Please take care of it.
What a twist!
How about that? We can get harpy feathers in the fractured version of Bermia Gorge. That'll be okay, won't it?
I thought that the only way to bring stuff from fractured dimensions to the real dimension was to have the key of Kresnik, aka L, who is currently with Bakor and not us. So how would that work? Or do you just need that for actual people? And you need the key of Kresnik to, like, bring fake Mila to this world. I don't know.
Have you put on more muscle? Like, right here and right there.
Oh, Muzet.
Yes, you've definitely filled out a bit. It's a good look for you. See how closely I've got my eye on you?
Oh, Muzet. To the fractured dimension! Away! And here we are. No idea where exactly I need to go, so we're just heading on forward. Let's check in here.
I don't mind keeping an eye out for harpies, but remember that our main objective is the Divergence Catalyst.
You think I don't know that?
It's gonna be like, the Divergence Catalyst is gonna be like some kind of a form of Folzam. The, Devil's Beast that was in Bermia Gorge in the first game.
Hey, Gaius, what's your favorite color?
I'm gonna try and make a guess. Either black or red.
My favorite color? Why would you ask that?
If I'm making accessories for everyone, it would be so cute if everyone got a different color!
Just curious, really. Humans have such a different sense of aesthetics than we spirits do.
Is that right? I do not have a preference. I'll use whatever color is most functional in a given situation.
Oh, you don't say.
Gosh, thanks for the help! I asked the simplest possible question, and you can't even throw me a bone!
But let's say someone was going to give you a present. What color would you want it to be?
Well, now you're just throwing all kinds of, like, sneakiness out of the window. Now he totally knows what you're talking about.
I see little value in being particular about such things. Perhaps Luger could be of more use to you in aesthetic matters.
Huh?
Muzet, if you like, I'd be happy to help. You're not dumping this off on me, Gaius. Yeah, you do this, Gaius.
Even you demand that I persist with this?
Would you just choose a color already, man? It's not hard.
All right, then. I suppose blue is a fine color.
Man, I was off. Why would he choose blue? Like, all he wears is black and red.
Blue? Well, that's a surprise.
My thoughts exactly.
It hasn't always been a favorite. But since I now associate it with you, Muzet, I have come to view it more fondly.
Ah, now that makes sense. Now it makes sense to me.
Huh. Oh, really?
Oh, wow! I had no idea Gaius had such a soft side!
Don't look at me like that. That's the most lip service I can muster. Just be happy I didn't make her upset.
Man, I love the skits and characters in this game. I don't really like Luger very much. I've said that as well. But for the most part, like, the majority of the characters in this game, and especially in Xillia 1, are amazing. I will never be able to say that enough. It's one of the things that made me fall in love with Xillia 1 and Xillia 2 now. Dang it, that rock is there. Why didn't anyone drop the rock shortcut in this dimension? What were the people thinking when they got to the top of the cliff? Like, oh, let's be douches and not open up the shortcut. Thanks, guys. Thanks.